Well, welcome to Theo Faith and welcome to In the Word. It's part of my ministry where I am in the Bible just about every day, 3 or 4 days a week, to encourage you to be in the Bible 3 or 4 days a week. You know, if you're in the Bible, I think it's 4 days a week, it'll have a transformative effect on your life. This is not just me saying it from a pastoral perspective, but there's actually research that shows that to be the case. So it's important that we're in the Word together and regularly, and this year we're going through the book of Psalms together. So we're on Psalm 116 today, really making a lot of progress. The end is in sight, so we'll push into 116. Before I go on, though, let me apologize. I'm a little bit behind. I had some things come up. I had a conference I was speaking at over the weekend, and things got out of control a little bit for me. And I'm a little behind on our reading plan for the Psalms, so I'll be catching up. But today we're in Psalm 116. I've called this a near-death experience. We've heard a lot about those, and they seem to be in the news from time to time. People see a light, and they see perhaps relatives that they've missed for a long time. Good thing to remember about near-death experiences is that they're not death, right? They're near death. And who knows what happens to our bodies and brains when we go through that. So I wouldn't take any theology from near-death experiences. But I would take this psalm. So this psalm is it's titled A Thanksgiving for Deliverance from Death. That's the editors put it in there. It's really a song of thanksgiving, a continuous thanksgiving. The psalmist has very deep, I think, profound gratitude for God rescuing him from a life-threatening situation. There's nothing in the psalm that really tells us exactly what the situation is. Some have thought it was a psalm of Moses when Israel was leaving Egypt during the Exodus. Others have seen this as a psalm that is celebrating the return to Jerusalem. In any case, what we see here is a psalm that just really is important for any of us who have had severe trials in our lives, severe setbacks, wondering what's happened and what are we doing and has God forgotten about me? So this is an important thing to remember that God doesn't forget. But verse 6 is our here verse, highlight, explain, apply, and respond. So let's look at this verse pretty closely here. I like that. The Lord preserves the simple. So preserve has a sense of keep watch over, keep safe. I like the simple. It refers to like a young, naive person. But I think the idea here is that when the psalmist found himself brought low, when he found himself facing a near-death experience. Notice he says at the end of beginning of verse 8, you rescued my soul from death, that he was young, he was naive, in other words, powerless. Trials bring us low, as we see in the second cola of the verse there, brought low. When we face trials, we become really helpless children, little tiny babies in so many ways, unable to save ourselves, unable to do anything for ourselves. And we really turn to the Lord in deep desperation. And this psalmist found that God saved him. This is an assurance of God's care for those who approach him with not only humility and simplicity, but I'd say desperation. That he saves those who are desperate, that they're at the end of the line, that they have been brought so low by the situation that they have no other recourse. And aren't we always in that situation? Sometimes death highlights it, but really we're always in that situation where we're dependent on the Lord. Thought about incidences in the New Testament. The widow of Nain, for example. Jesus met the funeral procession leaving the town of Nain, and her son had died, and how aggrieved she was. and how at her limit, really, and Jesus intervened and helped, or the death of Nazareth, where his friend died as a demonstration ultimately of God's power, but the his sisters, Martha and Mary, were thrown into deep sorrow. Paul's thorn in the flesh is another example of how God allows trials to come into lives to bring us low, to show his glory. So I think it's important to think about this and remember that, you know, God's not looking for some complex theology from us. He's not looking for some complicated formula. He's asking for a heart that trusts him. He's asking for a heart that's desperate for him. And he responds to that. He saves those people. So spend time in prayer today. I think, first of all, thanking God for the times that he's rescued you from difficulties. Maybe it wasn't as severe as a near-death experience. Maybe it was. But whatever that experience was that sticks in your mind, thank God for that. Join the psalmist. Reflect on moments in your life when you've been brought low, depressed, sorrowful. I know this past week I got some really bad news about a Bible teacher, a preacher, just an outstanding Bible preacher and teacher that I've recommended here, Steve Lawson, stumbled in sin, sexual sin, it seems. And what a crushing thing, really brought me low. And I really had to take that to the Lord and know that God was doing that in my life for a reason, to remind me not to focus on men, but to focus on him. So thank God for the times that he's rescued you. Reflect on those moments. And then one other thing I'd ask you to do is tell somebody about it. Share that with somebody at church, maybe a friend today, perhaps somebody who needs a word of encouragement. I think we've all got people in our lives that need a word of encouragement, don't we? So do that today. Encourage somebody with how God has preserved your life when you were brought low and how he intervened and saved you. God bless you, brothers and sisters. Enjoy this psalm. Enjoy Psalm 116, and we'll press on through the rest of them. God bless you.